What's the difference between these toy cars traveling at different speeds? Nearly everyone knows that the one moving faster, the one with greater speed, will go farther than the one moving slower in the same amount of time. Either that, or they will tell you that the one moving faster will get where it's going sooner than the slower one. Whatever speed is, it involves both distance and time. Faster means either farther or greater distance, or sooner, that is less time. Doubling one's speed would mean doubling one's distance traveled in a given amount of time. Doubling one's speed would also mean halving the time required to travel a given distance. Speed is directly proportional to distance when time is constant. V proportional to S for T constant. Speed is inversely proportional to time when distance is constant. V proportional to 1 by T for S constant. Here's another way to define speed. Speed is the rate of change of distance with time. In order to calculate the speed of an object, we must know how far it's gone and how long it takes to get there. Farther and sooner corresponds to faster. Let's say you drove a car from Pune to Mumbai. The distance by road is roughly 150 km. If the trip takes 3 hours, what was your speed? Applying the formula gives V is equal to S by T, which is equal to 150 km divided by 3R, which is 50 km per hour. This is the answer the equation gives us. But how right it is? Your speed during this journey must certainly have varied. The number calculated above is not the speed of the car, it's the average speed for the entire journey. An object with no movement at all has zero speed. In contrast, a car's speedometer shows its instantaneous speed, that is, the speed determined over a very small interval of time, an instant. In order to calculate the speed of an object, we need to know how far it's gone and how long it took to get there. A wise person would then ask, what do you mean by how far? Do you want the distance or the displacement? Your choice of answer to this question determines what you calculate, speed or velocity. Average speed is the rate of change of the distance with time. Average velocity is the rate of change of displacement with time. Speed and velocity are related in much the same way that distance and displacement are related. Speed is a scalar and velocity is a vector. Speed tells you how fast, velocity tells you how fast and in what direction. Speed and velocity are both measured using the same units. The SI unit of distance and displacement is the meter. The SI unit of time is the second. The SI unit of speed and velocity is the ratio of two, the meter per second. In our regular conversation, we measure speed in kilometer per hour. The ratio of any unit of distance to any unit of time is a unit of speed. The speeds of ships, planes and rockets are often stated in knots. 1 knot is 1 nautical mile per hour, which is equivalent to 0.5144 meter per second. The slowest speeds are measured over the longest time periods. The continental plates creep across the surface of Earth at the geological slow rate of 1 to 10 centimeter per year or 1 to 10 meter per century. About the same speed that fingernails and hairs grow. Sometimes the speed of an object is described relative to the speed of something else, preferably some physical phenomena. The speed of light in a vacuum is defined in the SI unit system to be 299792458 meter per second. Cheetah is the fastest running animal with a speed of 30 meter per second, while snails travel at speed that varies from slow, that is 0.013 meter per second, to very slow, 0.0028 meter per second. Velocity is a vector quantity. As such, velocity is direction aware. When evaluating the velocity of an object, one must keep track of direction. It would not be enough to say that an object has a velocity of 55 km per hour. One must include direction information in order to fully describe the velocity of the object. For instance, you must describe an object's velocity as being 50 km per hour east. This is one of the essential differences between speed and velocity. Speed is a scalar quantity and does not keep track of the direction. Velocity is a vector quantity and is direction aware. Now, let's consider the motion that physics teacher again. The physics teacher walks 4 meters east, 2 meters south, 4 meters west, and finally 2 meters north. The entire motion lasted for 24 seconds. Determine the average speed and the average velocity. The physics teacher walked a distance of 12 meters in 24 seconds. Thus, her average speed was 0.50 meter per second. However, since her displacement is 0 meters, her average velocity is 0 meters per second. Remember that the displacement refers to the change in position and the velocity is based upon this position change. In this case of the teacher's motion, there is a position change of 0 meters and thus an average velocity of 0 meter per second. Velocity can be 0 but speed cannot be 0. When the velocity of an object changes, it is said to be accelerating. Acceleration is the rate of change of velocity with time. A falling fruit accelerates, a car stopping at a traffic light accelerates, and an orbiting planet accelerates. Acceleration occurs anytime an object's speed increases or decreases, or it changes direction. Much like velocity, there are two kinds of acceleration, average and instantaneous. Average acceleration is determined over a long time interval. The word long in this context means finite, something with a beginning and an end. The velocity at the beginning of this interval is called the initial velocity, represented by the symbol V0, and the velocity at the end is called the final velocity, represented by the symbol V. Average acceleration is a quantity calculated from two velocity measurements. Calculating acceleration involves dividing velocity by time, or in terms of units, dividing meters per second by second. Dividing distance by time twice is the same as dividing distance by the square of time. Thus, the SI unit of acceleration is the meter per second square. Another frequently used unit is the acceleration due to gravity, G. Since we are all familiar with the effects of gravity on ourselves and the objects around us, it makes for a convenient standard for comparing accelerations. Everything feels normal at 1G, twice as heavy at 2G, and weightless at 0G. This unit has a precisely defined value of 9.80665 meter per second square. But for everyday use, 9.8 meter per second square is sufficient, and 10 meter per second square is convenient for quick estimates. Sliding along the slide in a park, car starting from rest and increasing speed, car coming to stop are some examples of acceleration. We discussed about velocity and acceleration of an object. We will explore how to capture this data in graphical form in next section. Take this challenge. As the ball rolls down this hill, which of these statements is true? Its speed increases and acceleration decreases. Its speed decreases and acceleration increases. Or both increase and both remain constant, or both decrease.